As you guys are quite aware by now, I traveled over the weekend with a couple others to the wacky Waco, Texas rally that Trump held and talked to Trump supporters, as I do from time to time. And it was wild, and I have another interview for you to watch for your viewing pleasure or pain. You'll just have to see. Now, so this interview was very interesting, as all of them are, but because it had to do with January 6th, and as we went through with the first interview I showed a few days ago, often the belief about January 6th is just so detached for many within the MAGA base from reality, and it's very concerning, and they think that the truth is being covered up by the mainstream media, and really it was a coordinated attack by the Democrats, and the Democrats caused it all. It's really bonkers. But without further ado, here is a couple that I talked to that believes this.
They had brought it up, and Pence had a chance to...
On January 6th?
Yeah. He had his chance to say what he needed to say, and then all of a sudden, the riot happened.
And they... Oh, I see where we're going.
Yeah. Yeah, the riot happened, and everybody had to flee.
And then by the time they come back in there, then they couldn't do it.
Okay. So, we gotta break this all down. It's okay. So, first we gotta start with, what do you think actually happened on January 6th? Who actually initiated it?
I think it was infiltrated by the FBI and people in Black Lives Matter.
Yeah. Now, you know that was all a ploy.
To do what, though?
Why would the MAGA supporters all of a sudden start creating havoc, mm-hmm, when they haven't done it before? Why would they do that?
Right-wing extremism is actually far more common than left-wing extremism.
Yeah, but they did.
But, oh, I gotta go back to it, though. The certification was going to certify Biden's win. The votes were there.
It was.
And Pence was going to do it. He was on board with certifying Biden's win before January 6th. So why would they want a riot that would prevent them from certifying it for the night?
Okay, but let's think about it, though.
You have to understand.
Pence was not on board. It's just when the person said, Pence said, do you have the names? They said, we have the name. Has it been approved by the Senate?
Yeah.
Or the... And just as he asked them that, bam!
That's when they
riot took off, and everybody had to rush.
So after they got,
but then they came back and did what they were going to do anyways.
Yeah, but they couldn't do it after they come back.
And then I got kicked out by security. It's interesting. I'll respond to that in just a second. But there was this one security guard, I guess you would call her, who kept moving back the line of where we were allowed to stand and interview people. Because the best way, as you've seen now in a few of these interviews, to interview people, just say, hey, can we walk with you in line so we're not preventing you from getting into the rally? And so we'd walk and talk, as you saw. And so then at one point, when we get up to the scanners, when people walk in, and obviously we'd turn around and go start talking to someone new, and the security guard was okay with that. And then I think as she realized, heard a little of the convos, realized I wasn't exactly MAGA, she was getting upset and moved that line further. Than it was way back by the end of the rally. We were getting punished for sharing our free speech. No, but that is kind of what played out. You saw a little bit of it there. That was like the first time. But it's so disturbing to me that something that played out on national television that is so thoroughly understood by most and is so clearly an attempt by supporters of a guy who spread a bunch of lies about our election to block the certification of who would become the next president. Still, conspiracy theories can run wild about that. Still, what we watched play out, Trump supporters who have this long record on social media of being Trump supporters in their personal life, still, those individuals can believe it was Antifa and BLM and, who knows, Pelosi coordinated it all, and it was to prevent Pence from blocking the certification, even though it was clear and thoroughly reported on that before any of the rioting happened or anything, he was not going to block the certification. He was going to do his process, do his duty that day, and do what absolutely he should have constitutionally and morally. But somehow it was an attempt to block the certification so that Pence couldn't reject certification, or so that the senators couldn't reject it, but it was going to be certified. The Democrats wanted, both for the sake of democracy and for Biden being the one who was going to be certified, the election to be certified, why would they coordinate something to block that and threaten their own lives? People trying to get Nancy Pelosi, why would Nancy Pelosi coordinate that? It doesn't make any sense. And my brain hurts from it. I do think that a little part of me is dying, and I'm going to be completely deceased by the time I go through enough of these rallies, because every time a little part of me, or at least my brain, dies as I hear these wild conspiracy theories in person. So pray for my health, we'll say. Make sure you're subscribed to this YouTube channel. Thank you very much.